Good evening.
Okay. My name is Sarah Brookhise, and if I haven't met you already, I teach the band and the orchestra alongside Mr. Kelm, who teaches our choirs here at Edsel Ford. Thank you so much for coming and supporting and being a part of our first concert of the school year. Choir's going to open.
Then we will have the orchestra. They're performing four pieces. Orchestra performs. We'll have an intermission where you're welcome to join us in the lobby for donation-only based concessions. Then we have the concert band, and I warn you kindly in the front row, the marching band and color guard are performing, so although you are welcome to sit there the first half, you are highly encouraged to not for the second half. Okay, without further ado, the choir. Thank you.
Thank you.
Okay, what's, oh yeah, there's microphones right there, that makes sense. Can I have one more round of applause for our awesome soloists? So this is my second year here at Edsel Ford as the director of choirs and the director of the theater program. When I started the school year, basically a year ago today, I had 3 students enrolled in my choir class. At the first concert, I had 12 singers on stage. I'm happy to showcase that I've got 22 eager, awesome singers that are up here right now. This makes me a really, really happy person because I think, and I know in the bottom of my heart, that I have the best job in the world. Oh, no, that means they're up to something. I'm just going to ignore that. I wanted to take a minute, though, to talk about the first song that we sang and then the one we just ended with. So both of them, if you look in your program, are actually arranged by the same person, a gentleman by the name of Dr. Gerald Custer. He is the adjunct professor of music theory and a few other things at Wayne State University. He's also my choir director at the First Presbyterian Church of Northville. He's been an amazing mentor figure for me. He's going to be coming in to work with the choir, and he gave me very express permission to use some of his pieces that he is internationally renowned for as a free will gift for my choirs as they've been growing. That last one we just did, Wade in the Water, was composed this summer to be performed by our church choir. So to my knowledge, this is the first high school performance of that piece. And I'm going to be singing it. Sending him a recording clip of our program here tonight as a thank you for all the stuff that he's been given. So I want to thank you all personally for really being awesome. But we have one more song that we're going to sing, and oh boy. Well, come on. You'll see why this is appropriate in a minute.
Oh,
Heart. It's by Alan Lee Silva. It's based on the book The Telltale Heart by Edgar Allan Poe. And enjoy.
Things like your kids' varsity letters, their music graduation cords, the performing arts, banquet, scholarship opportunities, et cetera, et cetera. We will see you back in a few minutes. All right, thank you so much. Okay. So we have the Edsel Ford Concert Band. They did a lot this semester, just like our other ensembles. They learned a ton of music, which was a very, very cool experience. There is a guest conductor for our first piece called The Cave You Fear. His name's Mr. James McLennan, and he was a fifth grade instrumental teacher last year, still instrumental at heart. He is in the midst of earning his master's in wind conducting at the American Band College, and one of his projects is to work with an ensemble and track the progress and, observe self, right? So he'll be joining us for our first piece, and then I'm taking my group back because I'm greedy. So without further ado, the Edsel Ford Concert Band. Thank you. breath and I wasn't playing anything. All right. Good job. Before we move on to our last ensemble, I like to get my thank yous in, so when that last note hits, you're like, and time to go. So big thank you to Miss Erin Inbody. In addition to playing beautifully for our choir and for our orchestra, she's been an absolute pleasure to work with as our piano accompanist, so shout out to her. She's in the wing house somewhere. Thank you. Miss Reem, oh yes, please, yeah. Miss Hassan and the Edsel Ford staff just as a whole is so supportive at this school, and we're really, really fortunate to be here. Her big thing is, what can I do to support? What do you need? What do you need? Where can we send them? What buses do we need to get? What instruments do you need? Like, she's been stellar since she walked in the door with our programs and wanting everything to be successful so that our kids could do this. You know, this is a privilege and it's amazing that we get to do this together, and we're really grateful for her and for them. To our middle school music teachers who don't get enough credit, because without them, this is not possible. They lay the foundation for everything, and without them, we don't have high school programs. So, like, huge kudos to them. The Lorini family, thank you once again for coordinating and making our concession sales happen on the back. So, kudos to Lorini. Thank you. Most importantly, to our students that do this, in my very, very humble opinion, they just bring so much joy with this activity and such a, like, a beautiful perspective to the things that you can do with your life. Thank you so much for coming.
Ladies and gentlemen, introducing Acme Detective Agency's
just been notified that Carmen San Diego, a rogue agent, has been located in Spain. She needs to be brought in for debriefing immediately. Good luck, agents.
Thank you.
Agents, I need a status update. Has Carmen been recovered? What do you mean she's in Africa? Don't let her get away.
And then you can go home. So I'm sitting over there, and I love being able to sit back and watch, because I never get to do that. And I'm looking around at the kids, and I'm like, choir, swim team, hockey, basketball team, the football team. The, like, your kids do so much, and they're amazing humans. And I'm really grateful to be your